millennials are. Don't you believe the new wave of millennials prefer convenience over loyalty? The coronavirus pandemic has catapulted digital transformation to the top of the must-haves in the minds of CIOs. It has been a go-to enabler for organizations to enhance their customer experience and generate higher ROI. Businesses with brick and mortar presence were shifting their approach towards building a digital presence to stay relevant and ahead of their competition. Many have already begun their digital transformation journey, while some are in the designing phase. Technology landscape is dynamic in nature. While the pandemic forced businesses to adopt digital diverses such as automations, big data, digital workforce, etc., they were soon replaced with the next big wave of digital transformation. This new wave has brought in new trends that will shape up the next normal. Needless to say, the new wave of digital technology trends can reduce human interactions, increase productivity, initiate automation, and simplify lives. Organizations need to understand the importance of this technology paradigm shift and leverage it to create digital ecosystems and become future-ready enterprises to welcome the next normal with both hands. Let's look into today's headlines in VAR India. The US Justice Department has sued to block Visa's $5.3 billion. The Department of Justice filed an antitrust lawsuit to block Visa's planned acquisition of fintech startup Plaid, alleging it would limit competition in the industry. Visa is a monopolist in online debit transactions, extracting billions of dollars in fees annually from merchants and customers. Plaid, a financial technology firm with access to important financial data from over 11,000 US banks, is a threat to this monopoly. The US Justice Department has sued to block Visa's $5.3 billion acquisition of bank data sharing startup Plaid, citing competition concerns. However, Visa says the effort is legally flawed and contradicted by the facts. PM Modi's address over virtual global investors roundtable. Speaking at the virtual global investor roundtable, PM Modi told foreign investors why they should invest in India. The focus was on discussions around India's economic and investment outlook, structural reforms, and the government's vision for the path to a $5 trillion economy. PM Modi added that the investors get demand with democracy, stability with sustainability, and growth with a green approach in India. PM Modi further said that India's quest for Atmanirbhar Bharat is not just a vision but a well-planned economic strategy. The saga behind GitHub getting hacked. GitHub has denied rumors of getting hacked after they found unwanted entry in the source code of the GitHub.com and GitHub Enterprise portals. The supposed source code was leaked via a commit to GitHub's DMCA section, said Nat Friedman, CEO GitHub. He further said the leaked source code did not cover all the GitHub's code but only the GitHub Enterprise server products. It is official, Python has overtaken Java as the popular programming language. The report from the TIOBE's index says Java has slipped out of the top two, leaving Python to occupy the spot behind reigning champion C. For the first time in its 20 years history, C and Java do not occupy the top two spots, with Java slipping to third and Python taking its place. With Python finally overtaking Java in popularity, the future could be one in which everything comes up Python. The reason behind this is due to the boom in data mining, AI, numerical computing, and other initiatives that commonly use Python's extensive data processing capabilities. McAfee detects 419 new cyber threats per minute in the second half of the year. McAfee unveiled its report that it saw an average of 419 new threats per minute, as overall new malware samples grew by 11.5% in the second quarter of this year. The global impact of COVID-19 prompted cybercriminals to adjust their cybercrime campaigns to lure victims with pandemic themes and exploit the realities of a workforce working from home. The report further says, McAfee saw a 605% increase in COVID-19 related attack detections compared to Q1. WhatsApp gets okay to go live for the payment service via UPI in India. The long waiting period of 2 years has completed for WhatsApp Pay, which has so far been operating pilot operations for users in India. Now onwards, WhatsApp Pay will join the overcrowded market of payment services offered via the UPI network. Google Pay, Phone Pay and Paytm are some of the largest processors of UPI payments apart from applications of individual banks. 30% cap for third-party UPI apps like Google Pay, Phone Pay, says NPCI. UPI, the Unified Payments Interface, has exceeded 2 billion transactions. The National Payments Corporation of India, that is NPCI, has set a cap of 30% on the total volume of UPI transactions processed by third-party app, that is TPA, providers, which will come into place from January 2021. NPCI has put a cap on the proportion of transactions that a single company can process in order to address the risks and protect the UPI ecosystem as it further scales up. This will largely affect Google Pay and Phone Pay and present an opportunity for others such as Paytm and MobiKwik. Cyber attack on Mumbai-based pharma company Lupin. There has been a cyber attack reported on the Mumbai-based pharmaceutical company Lupin. As reported, it did not have any impact on its operations. A statement from Lupin says, "We have recently experienced an information security incident that has affected several of our internal IT systems. This has not impacted our core systems and operations. However, the restoration of the impacted systems is a priority and is underway. We do not share data with Facebook, Google, Jio Platform," says to the parliamentary panel. Reliance spoke strongly in favor of data localization in India. Reliance Industries on Wednesday told the Joint Parliamentary Committee on the Personal Data Protection Bill that it does not have any data sharing mechanism with any third party such as Google and Facebook, even though they are among the company's investors. It further said that personal data is not shared even with entities under the Reliance Group. Festive shopping and gifting go digital during the pandemic. Indian homemakers are increasingly adopting digital payments and online applications for both work and entertainment, according to the latest EY report, that is Sentiments of India, Homemakers, Backbone of Our Homes. The behavior and consumption patterns of homemakers and their households across areas like digital adoption increased in shopping basket size, festive spending, work ambitions, and the evolving social dynamics of homemaking. Coming up, today it is not just about having the best products anymore. The new wave of millennials prefer convenience over loyalty. Today, the norm is creating digital experiences to support modern web in the form of progressive web apps, true native mobile apps with best-in-class UX, intelligent chatbots, conversational apps, wearables and immersive experiences that could leverage augmented reality. Organizations are trying to maximize the use of components and backend integration that leads to a unified and seamless experience across channels. The next big thing is customer experience, that is CX, is to design amazing applications for any audience across any device with no limits on user experiences, taking full advantage of the underlying devices, OS for native and full power of modern browsers for web. The omni-channel tools eliminate data silos and bring all the data at one place, be it a web presence, a physical store visit, or a mobile application click. Omni-channel binds all customer-facing interfaces together, integrates at the backend, and helps in better CX and data visibility across the board. Secondly, we have seen cloud is already adopted by most organizations to create seamless business continuity and a fast-paced go-to-market. Application programming interfaces, that is APIs, are the key in building economies of scale. From converting legacy infrastructure to microservices, APIs will help businesses to reduce data silos and create collaborative experiences. It will also help them convert scattered applications into one behemoth of the data mart, helping them in making critical business decisions and increase their overall ROI. Going forward, as a service, that is AAS, has already become the norm to become a truly digital native enterprise. The new trend in the AAS model is everything as a service, that is XAAS, where services rendered and delivered will completely reside on the cloud with virtual access to almost everything. Tools such as Internet of Things and artificial intelligence will play a crucial role in building those services or augmenting existing services to achieve the digital native status quo. With this, let's wind up for the day, but do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Please download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.